Another example that shows you how the real bravery, and I'm going to end with this, it's a beautiful story between Hassan al-Basri, between Hassan al-Basri and al-Hajjaj. So one time al-Hajjaj al-Yusuf al-Thaqafi, he built the castle. And what he said, he told everybody to see how, he wanted to show off his castle. So he let people in to show off his castle. People were saying, oh, I'm praising the castle. What a beautiful castle. So Al-Hasan al-Basri, when he heard this, what he said, فقام الحسن البصري and he said, لقد نظرنا فيما ابتنى أخفف الخابثين. فوجدنا أن فرعون اللعين أشد أعظم مما شيد وبنى أعلى مما بنى ثم أهلكه الله. We have seen this person who is the dirtiest of the dirt have built. And we have seen in the past that Fir'aun had built something higher than that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had destroyed it. Again, imagine, Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi was a tyrant. And people know how that no one messes with Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi. And now Hassan Basri is saying this out in the open. So people, some people, fear for Hassan Basri. Yeah, Hassan, don't say this. They're fearful for you that if Hajjaj have heard this from you, he would kill you. He would get rid of you. And that's exactly what happened. So Hajjaj ibn al-Thaqafi, he called him and he told the swordsman to be ready. And people were ready for them to and the people who want to punish him were ready for him. So Hassan al-Basri entered into the castle, okay, and then all of a sudden, Hassan al-Basri, he just kept remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then all of a sudden, as Hassan al-Basri entered the castle, Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi, he told him, Ya Hassan, come sit beside me. Let me ask you these questions. What's the ruling of that? And people, literally, their jaws are dropped looking at the picture. What happened to Yusuf? What happened to the Hajjaj? He got all the people ready for them to punish this guy. And all of a sudden, he is like a rabbit in front of them. What happened? So al-Hajjaj, when Hassan al-Basri had left the castle, he said, what happened to you? You were, we were thinking that, you don't want to kill the guy. What did al-Hajjaj said? He said, wallahi, as soon as this man walked into the castle, fear was dropped into my heart. And I was overwhelmed, and I could not do anything. And the only thing that I was able to do is start asking, to waste my time with them so he could leave. And then when they asked Al-Hasan al-Basri, what happened to you when you came in? He said, the only thing I did is I remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have confirmed me right from the side. So my dear istakbar sisters, out of the story, is we live in a times now where people change things, change the deen underneath many classifications, in which that, and people change in both extremes. Some people say, don't do this and don't say this underneath, and at the end of the day, they are being coward. In the same time, some people are doing things not underneath Islam, and they're being reckless. But Islam right in the middle, in which it tells you, look, man, in which that when you see something wrong, you stand far up for it, in the best ways, in the wise, in the most wisdom ways, but you show what is wrong. In the same token, you try to find out what the consequences are going to be. But that doesn't mean that you are quiet or you are killing people. And that's what the middle path of Islam is all about. And that's what Prophet Muhammad has taught us about.